we have, oh, Nada, are you present today? So there are a few children still, your video is off. I request everybody to switch on your video. Neha Mary, Sharanya, Sarang Das, Noel Joy, Nigel John, Efriya. Efriya, only today you are here. Neha, Sharanya, Mehul, Sarang. Please don't switch off your video. It should be on all the time. Abhinavaji and all. See, children, so we completed active and passive voice. How to change an active voice sentence into interrogative passive. Okay, interrogative active sentences into passive voice. The last one under active and passive voice. See, children, no, I have told you it is not possible for us to use the do forms in passive voice when we convert an active voice interrogative into passive voice. Remember, do forms. Instead of do forms, do, did, and does, we must use am, is, are, was, where, according to the tenses, according to the subject into the passive voice form. Okay, and remember, if your sentence is a question, if it is an interrogative question in active voice, when you convert an interrogative sentence, active voice sentence, into passive voice, the same sentence must be ending with a question mark. Okay, so interrogative sentence and active voice and passive voice, both the sentences are in the form of a question, so it must be ending with a question mark. Okay. Okay, and let me repeat, if your sentence, if your active voice sentence, your interrogative active voice sentence is starting with do form, like do, does, or did, you cannot use it in the passive voice form. Instead of that, you need to use am, is, are, was, where, be forms in the passive voice form. Okay, and next point, if your sentence is actually starting with, if your question is starting with the have form. Okay, have forms are have, has, had. Okay, if your interrogative sentence is starting with the have forms, remember, you can use the same have form in the passive voice sentence. Okay, but remember, if your subject is singular, if your question is starting with the have, it must be used has in passive voice. Okay, so you can use the same have form to begin your question there in the passive voice. Same time, modal auxiliary. If you have a modal auxiliary or question words except who and whom, remember, except who and whom, if your question word, if your WH words, if you are starting your interrogative active voice starting with WH word, except who and whom, okay, you can start your passive voice sentence with the same WH question word. Okay, if your question is starting with the WH or who, you begin your passive voice sentence, or
by whom
is changed into by whom in passive, and who is changed into whom is changed into who in passive voice. Okay. By, see, remember, if your WH question word is who, 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 you cannot begin or you cannot use who in the passive voice, because when you change the sentence into passive voice, you must begin your sentence with by whom. Clear? By whom. At the same time, if your sentence is starting with the whom, the word, the question word whom, you can start your passive voice sentence with who. Okay, this is what we discussed in the previous class, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let me share active and passive voice interrogative, this slide for you. I hope you have completed the notes, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, there is a formula for infinitive. For 7th standard student, there is no need for studying this rule. Okay, you concentrate on the three tables. You please concentrate on the three tables and imperative sentences. You please don't don't spend more time on interrogatives, and don't spend too much time on infinitives. Okay, so look at the sentence here, children. Look at the sentence here. First one. Did she recognize you? Okay, the sentence is, did she recognize you? Okay, here she is the subject, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
You is the object. Agree?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
So I'm going to write the same sentence here. Did she recognize you? And it is an active voice interrogative sentence ending with a question mark. No, I have told you, we cannot use, if your question is starting with a do form. See, did shows that, what is the tense of this particular sentence? Tell me the verb of the sentence.
Past.
past.
Okay. Did plus recognize shows that the sentence is given in simple past tense. Okay. The sentence is given in simple past tense. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
She recognized you. So did recognize shows that the sentence is given in simple past tense. And she is the subject of the sentence. You is the object of the sentence. Agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
As I have told you, it is not possible for us to use the do forms in passive voice. So which form must be used here?
B forms.
And you are familiar, the B forms are am,
am, is, are, is, where, is, was, are,
was,
and
was, am, is, where, am, is, are, was, where,
the, be. These are the B forms in English grammar. Okay, am, is, are, was, where. As you said, the sentence is in simple past tense. I cannot use am, I cannot use is, and I cannot use are. Okay, there are two options, either was or where must be used. Now we need to choose this right B form here to begin your question. No, according to the active and passive voice rules, you know, you, the object becomes the subject in passive voice and the subject goes into the place of object, right? So your subject is you. Okay, passive voice subject is you. Agree?
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Agree? So you,
yes,
along with you, which word can be used, was or where?
Where?
We must use where.
Because it is
plural. As you, along with you, we can use only where. So how to begin your sentence, children?
Where you
recognized by her.
Where is where the question you... word, the auxiliary verb here. Where, and the object of the active voice becomes the subject in passive voice. So where you, and you know, we have got the B form. Now we need to use the past participle form of this verb. Isn't it? So what is the past participle form?
Recognized.
Okay. And I should use the preposition by before the object of the passive voice. She becomes?
Her.
Object pronoun. So I got the sentence. And how to punctuate the sentence, children? How to punctuate the sentence?
Question mark.
Yeah, question mark. See, children, our first question is, it is a question. It is an interrogative sentence. It is a question sentence. So this is an active voice. When you convert an interrogative question sentence into passive voice, you must give a question mark at the end of the passive voice. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Is that clear for you guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So look at the second sentence here. Who wrote this poem? I have told you, if your active voice sentence is starting with the word who, okay, we cannot use who, or we cannot begin our passive voice sentence with the word. Instead of that, we must begin it with by whom. Okay. So who wrote this novel? So please look at here. Who wrote this book? Who wrote this book? It is an interrogative sentence ending with a question mark. Okay. So the question is starting with the word who. I cannot use the same question word in passive voice. Who is changed into?
By whom?
Okay, wait. Now wait. Okay, so I must begin my passive voice sentence with by whom. Look at the sentence and tell me your active voice sentence is in which tense form?
Past tense.
How did you identify it?
Wrote.
Yes. The verb wrote shows that the sentence is in simple past tense. Agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Tell me the object of the sentence.
Book.
Only book?
This book
is the object of the sentence. Okay. So now you tell me, there is a pattern, or how can we frame a sentence? How can we frame a question?
By whom was this book written? Question word plus auxiliary verb plus subject plus main verb
ending with the question mark. This is the pattern of setting a question, isn't it? So we have got the question word by whom. Okay, now you tell me, as you said, the sentence is given in simple past tense. Which B form I should use it here in the form of an auxiliary verb?
Was.
As it is in by whom was
This book written.
Very good. This book written. This book written past participle form. By whom was this book written? Question mark. As this is an interrogative sentence, this book is a singular subject. So I should use was here and past be form plus past participle form and passive voice. See, was plus written. Okay. So this is an example for passive voice. So who is changed into by whom in passive voice? And this book is a singular subject. So I have to use was here as by auxiliary verb or as in the be form and the past participle form of the verb write must be written here. Okay. The pattern of setting a question is question word plus auxiliary verb plus subject plus main verb. See, by whom was this book written? This is how you should, and remember an interrogative sentence is always ending with a question mark. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Look at the third sentence, children. Look at the third sentence. 1 second. Okay. Look at the third sentence. Have you finished the work? I have told you, if your sentences are starting with the have forms, like have, has, had. Okay. If your sentences are starting with have, has, had, you can use the same word to begin your sentence, right? You can use the same word to begin your sentence. Then why I have chosen has to begin this question? The question is actually starting with the have.
Ma'am, because the verb.
Because? Okay, let me explain this to you. I'm going to write the same sentence on the board. Have you finished?
According
have you finished the work? Okay. This is a question, interrogative sentence. Okay. Now we are going to change the sentence.
And the work is singular.
Ah, excellent. So before jumping into that, let me, could you please tell me the sentence is in active voice or passive voice?
I'm active.
It is an active voice. How did you identify?
Ma'am.
Tell me the final verb of the sentence.
Ma'am, finished.
Why is finished? Finished.
Only finished. Finished means what is the tense of the sentence? Finished means the sentence past. Is in simple past tense, right? But yes, the sentence no, is not yes, in ma'am. Simple past tense. It is in present perfect. See, auxiliary you verb plus main have verb. Finished. Have finished is the verb of the sentence. Okay. The sentence is in present perfect. Present perfect, not in past form. Okay.
Ma'am,
have you
used.
Finished? So when you change the sentence into a declarative sentence, you can write like this. You have finished the work. Okay. So have finished is the finite verb over here, which shows a tense form. Okay. The tense of the sentence is actually present perfect tense. So you got the present perfect tense now and you got the verb here, and tell me the subject of the sentence, children.
You.
You is the subject.
You.
Agree? Object of the sentence?
The work.
The object of the sentence. Okay, excellent. Now we have got the verb and we understood the tense of the sentence is in present perfect. Okay, present perfect. And we got the subject of the sentence and we have got the object of the sentence. So how to change the sentence? Don't look at the answer written on the board here. You just try to answer to my question. Okay. How to change the sentence into passive voice form? That should be a question. You know,
remember
if a question word is missing, you can begin your interrogative sentence with auxiliary verbs. So how to change the sentence? Don't look at the answer written on the board.
Has the work.
Why has?
Has the work.
Why has?
One work is singular.
Yes, the work is singular. So you can use the word has to begin your sentence. Okay. So has?
The work.
The work.
Remember, the sentence is in present perfect sentence, right?
Ma'am,
yes, ma'am. Because has the word been?
Given you three tables. One table for the present tense, the other table for past tense, and the third one for future tense. Take the table of present perfect. How did you change a present perfect sentence into its passive form?
What we will add the be form.
We have to use
been.
You have to use been in it. So, okay. So now you tell me how to change it.
Has the work been finished by you?
Excellent. Has the work been? Only one. Only one Shane John is present here in this class. As I can hear his own voice here, nobody else is responding. Only Shane John is present. What about others? Has the verb been? Past participle form of the verb finish is finished. Has the verb been finished?
By you.
By you and put a question mark at the end. Yes, someone is calling me.
Ma'am, your video is off.
Okay, my video is off. Is that clear now?
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, so this is how you should change a sentence from interrogative active voice into passive voice. Remember, children, the same topic is there for the 8th standard also. If you study this time, next time it will be very easy for you guys. Okay, so children, concentrate here. This time, for the exam point of view, you need to study the 3 boxes. Okay, and the imperatives. Interrogatives won't be there. Okay, so study imperative sentence from active to passive voice. Study the 3 boxes, how to change, try to identify the verb by looking at the finite verb and try to change with the help of 3 boxes which is there with you. You can match any sentences with the 3 boxes which is there in your hand, and you can easily convert such sentences into passive voice if you are thorough with the active and passive voice, the tense box, the 3 tense boxes. Okay. Are you able to follow me?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you understanding what I am taking here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
If there is any difficulty in the topic where I need to repeat, I am ready to repeat. So you have to tell me the areas that I should repeat. Okay. Okay, children.
Ma'am,
now
can
tell
you,
me. Dia?
Ma'am, can you explain it once more?
Which one? Interrogative?
No, ma'am. The third question.
Third question. Have you? Yes, of course. Very good. See, children, I think this is very familiar. As look at this question written here. Have you finished the work? The first step is to identify the tense of a sentence by looking at the finite verb. Okay? Here you try to identify the verb first.
Have finished
is the verb. Okay, so have finished, if it is a verb or if it is a finite verb, try to predict the tense form of that particular sentence.
Past perfect.
Have finished. Have is actually in past tense. Dia, comes in past tense, or have is present only in present tense. Have finished
present.
Is the
present
verb
tense.
And have finished is the, actually the finite verb, which shows that the sentence is given in present perfect. Okay, now you tell me the subject of the sentence.
You.
Tell me the object of the sentence.
The work.
So you have got the verb. Have finished, and you know that the sentence is given in present perfect, and you said you is the subject of the sentence, and you said the work is the object of the sentence, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we are going to change the sentence into passive voice. As we are clear with the tenses, as we are clear with the subject and object of the sentence, we are planning to change this interrogative sentence into interrogative passive voice. Okay. So how I got the word has here? That is your question, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, because you know, when we convert an active voice sentence into passive voice, the subject goes in the place of an object. And object becomes the subject. Agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so based on the subject only, see, you learned subject verb agreement in the previous
term, ma'am.
Right? A few months before.
Yes,
you completed a topic called subject verb agreement, where the basic rule is, if your subject is singular, use a singular verb. If your subject is plural, use a plural verb. So here the subject is the work. Okay, here the subject is the work. Tell me, Dia, whether the work is actually called a singular subject or a plural subject.
Singular.
It is singular. So which word can be used with a singular subject?
Have.
If you because have is the plural form, so you can begin your sentence with has only. That is how you have got the word has here. Okay, so has singular and the work is singular, so has the work. And you know, Dia, you take the column of present perfect tenses. Take, you have three tenses with you, three boxes with you. Take the column of present perfect passive. Read present perfect active sentence and read present perfect passive.
Renu has sung a song.
Renu has sung a song. Okay, that sentence is actually in present perfect. Renu has sung, because has sung is the finite verb. Look at the passive voice column. How did you change it into passive voice?
A song has been sung by Renu.
So we must use been in passive voice, right? If your sentence is given in present perfect, when you convert this present perfect sentence into passive voice, there is it is a must that you should use the word been in it, right?
Been.
So the same formula we have applied here, that is has the work, and the sentence is in present perfect. So has the work, you know, we need to use been in the sentence if the subject is present perfect. If it is in past perfect also, you need to use been. If your sentence had you finished your work, if the question is had you finished your work, how to change that particular sentence into passive voice. See, suppose your sentence is had you finished the work. Okay, this is your sentence. Okay, now children, this is an interrogative sentence. We need to change the sentence into passive voice form. Okay, agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now I have a few questions to you. Nihal, you tell me the tense of the sentence, or you tell me the verb.
Had finished.
Very good. Had finished is the verb, and tell me the tense of the sentence.
Past perfect tense.
Yes, the sentence is in past perfect. Okay, thank you. So next question, Annette Rus. Annette, you tell me the subject of the sentence.
You.
Okay, thank you. Subject we have got you. Okay, Abhinav Aji, tell me the object of the sentence.
The work.
The work. Okay, the work is the object. Same, right? Only one change had. So Priyanna, how can I begin my passive voice sentence? Just begin the sentence. As I have started with had, it is in past tense. I need to change this past tense into its passive form, interrogative passive form. So how can I change the sentence into passive, Priyanna? I cannot hear, Priyanna. You mute it. Which auxiliary verb or which question word I should use to begin my sentence? Priyanna, mute it. Unmute. Naveen?
Yes, ma'am.
Naveen, you tell me how can I begin my sentence, passive voice sentence? Had you finished the work? See here, have you finished the work? As the work is singular, I started with has. Okay, here my sentence is actually using had. There is no change with the singular subject and plural subject if the sentence is starting with had. I can use the same had. So Diya, how to begin my sentence here?
Had you work?
Okay, had, thank you. Had the work. As this is in simple, as this is in past tense, past perfect, there is no change of the word had with the singular subject and plural subject. We can use the same had the word with singular subject and plural subject. Okay. So now you tell me, had the work
been finished by you?
It is in past perfect. So I must use been here. Okay. Had the work been
finished by you?
Finished by you. There is no change, right? Look at the sentence, present perfect sentence and past perfect sentence, almost same, right?
Yes, ma'am.
It is almost the same. There is no change. Dion, are you following me?
Yes, ma'am.
Dion, are you getting all these concepts clear? Is that clear for you guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Vijin, you are looking at someone and smiling. I don't know, is it me
or not?
Yes, Vijin, are you able to follow what am I teaching here?
Yes, ma'am.
Sharanya, are you getting it? Where is my crying puppet? Efren. Efren Ami. Are you able to follow the class?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sharanya.
Yes, ma'am.
Devanarayan. Dev. Okay. Advait.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I can see many videos are off. What about Neha Mary? Neha.
Yes, ma'am.
Where is my gentleman? Jagan Krishna. Jagan, are you able to follow? No, ma'am, a smoke is coming out of my head. Don't worry. I'll cool it with ice pack. Okay. So don't worry. If you have anything to ask me, you must ask it now. Okay. Okay, children, you can ask now itself. You clear your doubt now itself. Okay. Let me share another question for you guys. Look at the sentence here. 1 minute. Vijin, today you are very silent. What happened? Ma'am, I cannot
do this,
isn't it? Okay, now you look at the sentence here. So we have completed, has you finished the work? And now you look at the next sentence, will you? Will is a modal auxiliary, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes, yes or no? Will yes. is a modal auxiliary verb.
Yes, ma'am.
So according to or by rule, if your sentence is starting with a modal auxiliary, you can use the same modal auxiliary to begin your sentence. Only one condition.
Yes, ma'am.
If it is will or shall, it is very clear that the sentence is in future tense, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no?
Yes,
you're
ma'am.
Not responding.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Come with a lot yes, of this, that, an active and buzzy yes, voice in the morning, and she's just spoiling our mood. Okay. So do one thing. So will or shall? I'm going to write the same sentence here. Will you help him? Don't look at the answer here. It is a question word. So the sentence is an interrogative sentence, isn't it? Now, children, you yes, tell ma'am. Me the verb of the sentence. Remember, if there is any auxiliary verb is present in the sentence, you must attach it with the main verb in the sentence.
Will help. Will help. Will help.
Excellent. Will help. So tell me the tense of the sentence. We have got the finite verb.
Future.
Will help.
Future.
Tell me the tense form.
Future.
It is
simple
it is
future.
In, yeah, simple the sentence is
simple future.
Simple future. Very good. The sentence is in simple future. Excellent. The sentence is given in simple future tense because the finite verb is will help, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, we have got the sentence, the idea of the tense now. Okay, now you tell me the subject of the sentence.
You.
Very
you.
Good, very good, very good. You is the subject of the sentence. Okay, tell me the object of the sentence.
Him.
Very good, very good. Him is the object of the sentence. Excellent. See, look at here. So we have got, remember children, we have got the tense form of the sentence. We have got the subject of the sentence. We too have got the object of the sentence. Now we are going to change. I think all of you are sitting with the three tables with you. Take the yes, table yes, of ma'am. Future tense. Look at the column. See the column, simple future tense column. How did you change Renu will sing a song into passive voice? See, I'm going to write the sentence here. Renu, wait. Renu will sing a song. Okay? This was your sentence in simple future then. Declarative sentence. And you said will sing is actually the finite verb of the sentence. And the sentence is in simple future. Right?
A song will be sung by Renu.
Okay. Okay. Excellent. So your subject becomes the object and object becomes subject. Okay. So you should begin your sentence in passive voice with a song.
A song will be sung by Renu.
Very good. Will be sung. Past participle form of the verb. Will be sung by?
By Renu.
Renu.
Okay, Renu. We got the sentence. Excellent. Okay. A song will be sung by Renu. So we got the sentence declarative in active voice. We know how to change an active voice sentence into passive voice. If the sentence is in simple future tense. Now, will you help him? Will you help him? It is also in simple future.
Wait.
I know you're thorough, but still, it is also in simple future. So how to change the sentence into passive? The question is to Advait Thaivalat, right?
Yes, okay,
Advait, Advait, will you help him? You got the subject, you have got the verb, and you have got the object, and now you said it is in simple future tense, and I have a declarative sentence here to check your answer. Okay, now you tell me, how can I change this interrogative sentence into passive voice? Remember, you can begin your, if your sentence is starting with an auxiliary, modal auxiliary verb, you can begin your interrogative passive voice with the same modal auxiliary. Efrin, try. Efrin, try to give me the answer.
Ma'am, will he...
Wait. Excellent. Will... Your question word is same. Auxiliary, modal auxiliary. Okay. Will... Him
he?
Is actually object pronoun. Excellent. Excellent, Efrin. Efrin, I mean, it's good. Okay. Will he... I...
Be...
Ah, you're right. You're will... right. Be...
Will he... Helped...
Will he be... Ah.
Helped by you.
Ah, the word is not helped. It is helped. H-E-L-P-E-D. Helped. Okay. So, will is the the starting of this question. It is a modal auxiliary. So, if your interrogative sentence is starting with a modal auxiliary, you can use the same modal auxiliary to begin your question in passive voice. And the object of the active voice becomes the subject here. As him is an object pronoun, what is the subject pronoun used instead of him? That is he. Okay?
He.
So will he, see, look at here, a song will be sung. So by rule, you are thorough that after a modal auxiliary, we can use only the base form of be, right? So will he be helped by, completed?
By you.
By you.
By you.
Okay, by you. And how can I punctuate the sentence?
Question mark.
So interrogative active voice sentence, when we convert it into passive voice, this is identify the tense form, identify the subject, identify the verb, identify the object, and it is easy for you to convert the sentence into passive. Okay, and the last one for today, one more exercise. I am requesting Saranya to help me to solve this problem, or so to find answer for this question. Okay, your question is, does Saranya, does he help you? I have a few questions now. It is an interrogative sentence. Tell me the tense of the sentence, Saranya. Try. If you are wrong, also don't worry. I want your response.
I'm simple present.
Simple present. How did you get it? Tell me the finite verb here. You're right, Saranya. You're right. The sentence
help.
Is simple. Only help. No other auxiliary verb here.
Does help. Does help.
Ah, does help. Very good. Does help. This is the finite verb. Okay. Now you said the sentence, this particular sentence is in simple present tense. Okay.
Yes,
simple
ma'am.
Present tense. And I have told you, see, the sentence is starting with the do form, right? And this do forms cannot be used in passive voice. Okay, if I cannot use this to begin my question in passive voice, which question word I should use? Okay, wait. See, look at the subject of the sentence.
He.
He. Okay, he is the subject of the sentence. Tell me the object of the sentence.
You.
You. Okay, you is the object of the sentence. Got it? So does he help you? So does help is the verb and the sentence is in simple present tense. He is the subject and you is the object. Okay. So by rule, I should interchange the position of subject with object and object with subject. Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Isn't it? So, so tell me the subject of the passive voice now. Saranya, I cannot hear you. Saranya, are you there? Saranya?
Ma'am, she is speaking, but we can't hear.
She is speaking. I cannot hear Saranya.
Her mic is not working.
Her mic is not working. Sharanya, I cannot hear you and I cannot see you here on the screen also. Sharanya, no, my dear, I cannot hear you. Your mic is not muted, but still I cannot hear your sound. Could you please adjust your mic and speak? Oh, now you're muted. Unmute it. Speak once again. No, my dear, no, I cannot hear. So Akash Krishnan, sorry, Sharanya.
Yes,
no problem. I'll give you another question. Okay, you just check your mic. Okay, Akash Krishnan, how can you change the sentence into passive voice? Does he help you? As you have got a few replies from few answers from Sharanya, she said the sentence is in simple present tense. She said he is the subject and you is the object. How can you begin this question? How can you change this question into passive? Does we cannot change. Okay. So instead of does, which forms can be used?
B forms.
So which B form is suitable here?
R.
Why R? You are right. I should begin my sentence with R.
Because does is plural.
You. Because?
You is plural.
Okay, because of you, I should begin my question with R. Okay, fine. So,
are you helped.
Excellent. Are you helped?
By? Him.
Wonderful. Very good. Very good. Him. Okay. So, which punctuation mark I should give it here? The right punctuation. Yeah, I cannot use a full stop. I have to use a question mark to end my sentence. Okay? Okay, children? So this is called, or this is how. No, we have done many exercises, right? So remember, children, this is how we should change our active voice sentence into passive voice if it is an interrogative sentence. So you have a few points to remember when you convert a sentence from active voice to passive voice if it is an interrogative sentence. See, if your question is starting with the do forms like do, doesn't, did, you cannot use do, doesn't, did to begin your passive voice sentence. Instead of that, as Akash Krishnan said, you must use B forms. Okay, B forms are am, is, are, was, where. According to the subject, if the subject of the passive voice is plural, you must begin with if it is present tense, you must begin with R. Okay, if it is singular, if it is in present tense, you can begin, you can use with is. Okay, so singular subject, if it is a singular subject, you can use singular verb to begin, singular B form to begin your question. You cannot use do, doesn't, did in passive voice. It does not appear. Okay, it does not appear in passive voice form. And remember, if your sentences are starting with have, has, had, okay, you can use the same words to begin your question when you convert a question into passive voice form. Remember, all of you must identify the finite verb first before you are doing or before you're transforming a sentence from active to passive voice. Clear? Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
And second, yes, ma'am. And the third point I said, children, if your sentence is starting with the modal auxiliaries like will, could, would and all, may, can and all, you can use the same modal auxiliary. We have done a few exercises over here, right? So, see, we can use the same modal auxiliary to begin our sentence, okay? Okay, and the last point I said, see, WH words can be used as the same, or we can use, or we can begin our passive voice form using this WH words which is actually given in the used in the active voice sentence. But two exceptional cases, what are the two? Can you tell me the two exceptional cases WH words which I cannot use to begin my passive voice?
Who is becoming by whom?
Excellent. Very who? Good. So who cannot be used instead of who? If your
by
sentence
who
in active,
who?
Yeah. If your sentence in active voice,
by whom beginning. And who?
Excellent. Who is changed into by whom in passive voice and who
by
into
whom is changed
who?
Into
so
who?
Remember all these points. Wish you all the best for the coming examination. Next class onwards, we will start revising our topics. We have two topics to cover. Okay, so those two topics, transformation of sentences and active and passive voice, are there for you to write the examination. Remember, children, you concentrate in transformation of sentences and you concentrate in active and passive voice, declarative sentences and imperative sentences, not interrogative. Okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am.